Who's the clown now? Clown wears my butt. We finally have actual content for Netflix's Shadow and Bone adaptation. True, we had a teaser last month and it was a good start and I made a video about it. You can go ahead and watch it if you missed it. And by the way, there's tons of Grisha content on this channel and there will be more, so don't forget to subscribe if you don't want to miss them. But anyway, that teaser was not actual content. It was just a CGI stag and the crow. Anyone could have made a video with a CGI stag and a crow. Apparently Netflix thought that was good content. But you know, it was nice because we got a release date. We relaxed a bit knowing the show wasn't dead because we hadn't heard in a while from them. But this time we have actual content to talk about. So we'll go over the Entertainment Weekly article and we'll check out the photos from the show and we'll check out the character posters. I'm excited about these photos. They look pretty great. I have some criticisms on some of them, but before we start that, we have a definitive release date now. We knew it was going to be April, but this article now tells us it's April 23rd. Kind of a bummer that it's late April, but you know, I'll take it. All right, the article opens with the photo of Ben Barnes as the Darkling, and he sure is the Darkling. They call him General Kerrigan in the show. I think that's nice. I personally think Darkling is a bit of a silly name. I talked about it in my other videos, so I like that it's going to be more of a secret title than his actual name. Right, he is the Darkling of Ravka. Also, I'm guessing this is his kefta. It looks cool. We have a closer look in one of the posters. Let's talk more about it then. Lee Bardugo says, Shadow and Bone takes place in a very different kind of fantasy world. Think Imperial Russia, not medieval England. Repeating rifles instead of broadswords. It's a story about the people who have been told how much they don't matter, proving how much they do. And it's been incredible to see that story take shape on such an epic scale. The battles, the magic, but also the relationships between the characters. These photos give just a tiny hint at what's in store. A map maker with an extraordinary gift. She's talking about Alina here. The people who want to use her. Darkling. The tracker who will do anything to protect her, that is Mal, and the team of thugs and thieves who are about to cause some very big trouble for everyone involved. She is talking about the crows here. We still don't know how they're going to be involved in the events of this show. They're combining Shadow and Bone with Six of Crows because Six of Crows is better. I get it, okay? It's better. Gotta do what you gotta do. Still no details on how exactly that's going to work. I'm cautiously optimistic. Again, I talked about this a lot in some other videos if you want to hear more about that. Eric Heiserer, who is the showrunner, says those photos offer a glimpse into the expansive, textured world Lee created in her books. We work tirelessly to craft a lived-in feel for fictional lands like Ketterdam and Ravka with invented languages, uniforms, currency, and artistic choices from set design to costuming. You're immersed in the Grishaverse when you read, and it's our hope that both new and existing fans have that same feeling when they watch the show. Then we have a photo of Jessie Mae Lee as Alina Starkov. You can see the sand skiff behind her. She's also wearing a blue gold scarf. Heiser says she's on board a sand skiff, which is a vehicle used to cross the Shadow Fold, a sort of supernatural barrier and a dangerous crossing. Lee Bardugo says, I love this photo because you see a Alina in the moment right before her life is really about to change. What if your country was cut off completely from your coastline and you had no way to trade with the outside world? It would effectively cripple your ability to trade and do business. So they send people who are largely considered expendable into the Shadow Fold. Also, people who are familiar with the book will know that scarf around her neck is a hint at what's coming down the road for her. I'm guessing she's talking about Alina's kefta, which was blue and gold because she belongs to the Order of Summoners. Then there's another photo of Alina, this time with her childhood friend Mal, played by Archie Renault. Heiser says he's a tracker in the First Army. There are two main armies in Ravka that work at side by side. The First Army is for all the non-magic soldiers. The Grisha, who are the people that possess magic in this world, make up the second army. So we're getting a glimpse at a first army camp in a city near the Fold. And Leigh Bardugo adds, they grew up together at an orphanage, and it's only that they're being drafted into the first army that they're being separated. So when they reunite, as we see in this picture, there's a lot of love and camaraderie there. We can also get a glimpse at Ravkan soldiers in the background. We can sort of see some of their costumes. They're very greenish, soldier-like, I guess. It's going to be a nice contrast with the colorful keftas of the Grisha. I think it's going to look great. I wish we got a Zoya photo because I really wanted to see the colorful keftas, of course. When are we seeing those keftas, Netflix? You cowards. Stop making us dig for shitty leaked photos. I guess the Darklings photo is sort of a first look at the keftas. There's another photo of Mal. I love this photo. I think it looks cool. It looks like it's nighttime-ish. It's snowing and there's a light shining on Mal. I don't know if it's fire or if this is the scene from the first book. Let's not get into too much spoilers, I guess. I assume only the fans of the book will be watching this video, but who knows, maybe we have newcomers. Then there's the photo of the Darkling again. Love the kefta, very nice. Leigh Bardugo says, we really lucked into somebody extraordinary to play this role. Because General Kerrigan, he's not immortal, but he's so powerful that he borders on immortal. Ben has this wonderful Aegis quality that works beautifully. Agreed, he's pretty much perfect for this part. And also, if you check Leigh Bardugo's tweets years ago, she was imagining him as the Darkling for quite some time now, so glad she got that. Then we have our first look at the Six of Crows gang. Only three of them here. Wylan is not going to be in this season, and I'm not sure Nina and Matthias will meet the Crows either. But here we see Jesper, Inej, and Kaz. Jesper's style is super on point. He has a nice top hat, and I love Inej too. We can't see much of her costume here, but we have another photo of her we're going to talk about. Not super sure about Kaz. That coat looks a bit too large and boxy to me. It's hard to say, but I'd rather have a well-fitted coat. But cool fedora, I prefer a little bit larger brims on my fedoras, but I'll take it. Heiserer says, we pitched the storyline as Ocean's 11 meets Game of Thrones. Dude, I'm just gonna lose my mind with everyone comparing everything to Game of Thrones. So this book literally has nothing in common with Game of Thrones. Imagine the most distant book from Game of Thrones. This is probably somewhere there. It has nothing to do with it. I just don't understand. Yes, they're both fantasy, I guess. So that's a similarity. But yeah, if you haven't read the books, they're not similar to Game of Thrones. Anyway, he continues. These are three of our crows, a criminal element who have a mission all their own. How it dovetails in with the Grisha trilogy storyline, I hope will be very exciting for our fans. Jesper is an accomplished gunslinger. He's an amazing crack shot. Inej is very good at being quiet and with knives. She carries around 14 knives. Bardugo adds, Kaz on the right is the mastermind of the crew, and he's like a much less suave and much more violent Danny Ocean. Then we have this super cool photo of Inej with her knife, loving the costume and her attitude here. Bardugo says she's an assassin. You don't want to mess with this woman. She has a knife in her hand and she's got plenty more to back those up. Then we have our first look at Nina and Matthias. I speculated this would be the case, but I'm guessing this is the part from Nina's backstory where she and Matthias get sort of stranded together. Very excited to see this. I think this is one of the things that could work well for the Six of Crows portion of the show, because this is directly from the books. Bardugo says Nina is a Grisha spy and Matthias is a witch hunter from Fierda, an enemy country north of Ravka that despises and fears the Grisha. He and Nina are on a bit of a collision course. And then some final words from Leigh Bardugo. I'll just say these photos are just a tiny taste of some of the wonderful things that Eric and our team did with the show. They're very character focused, don't give a hint of the battles and spectacle that they achieved, but I also think it's great because they focus on the heart of the show. I agree, especially for the Six of Crows. It's a strongly character-driven novel, less so for Shadow and Bone. But these photos look pretty great. They make me excited for a show. They don't look cheap. There are going to be 8 episodes, and as I said, they will be available on April 23rd. But wait, there is more. They also released some character posters, so I want to go over them real quick and talk about them a bit too. Let's start with Alina. She's wearing her soldier uniform here. There's like a green smoke behind all of them. There's a symbol on her arm I don't recognize. It might be signifying her division as a map maker in the army. It's kind of a trivial skill she has in the books. I don't know if they will explore it more in the show. Probably not. The next poster is the Darkling, so I'm guessing this is his kefta, right? With black embroidery on black. Yeah, that makes sense. It has sort of clasps, I guess, instead of buttons. They sort of imitate an eclipse shape. It may be a bit too self-aware. This could be a decent look at the kefta design, but I expect a more coat-like outer kefta as well, right? This doesn't look like cold winter clothing. There must be something else you wear over this. He also has this cool ring. I don't really remember a ring. Remind me in the comments if this has any significance. Then we have this super cool Jesper poster. He has his guns. I love his jacket with turned up collars. He looks so cool. Love the etchings on the guns. Super elegant. Then we have Mal's poster. Again, there's this clasp type of design instead of buttons. There's a symbol on his coat, which I'm guessing is the Lantsov Eagle. So I would guess the symbol is actually the symbol for the First Army of Ravka. Then we move on to Kaz. Now, this coat is much more like it. I think this one looks pretty great. I love the gloves and, of course, his crow cane. The cane looks nice and weathered. Love it. Not sure about the gem in the eye, but I'll take it. I wouldn't want it to look too much like a luxury item, you know? He's also wearing the super elaborate waistcoat. And finally, let's end with Inej. A bit of an awkward pose. I think there could be a better pose here, but they're highlighting the knives. She's holding two, and we can see some throwing knives here too. The one thing about Inej's costume is that it looks very particular. You know, it doesn't look like Ketterdam to me. It looks too much like Suli clothing, and it feels a bit strange to me. Like, does she have a special tailor? I'm guessing nobody else dresses like this in Ketterdam. Another thing about the costumes of the crows is just they're all way too clean and slick for my taste. I'd really like them to be a bit more weathered and rugged, honestly. These look a bit too elaborate on the posters, but hopefully they will be more suitable in the show itself. But this is all we have. That was quite a lot of content. Hopefully we'll get some more content from now on. I don't expect to see the trailer until March, but who knows? Let me know your thoughts and your favorite photos in the comments. Don't forget to check the other Grishaverse videos I have on this channel. There will be a lot more. Some super interesting content is coming very soon. So don't forget to subscribe if you don't want to miss those. And I will see you next time. I am complete.